Hello and welcome back everyone. So what we are going to do in this video is we will create a order routes. So I think folder is there. So first we will do order.controller.ts. We will create a DTO also for this. DTO will be a class which will tell us what all we can accept. Order.service.ts and order.module.ts. Why it is showing DTO as an angular icon? Okay, this is some semantics. So controller and service. Now in controller it will be just a simple class. Export class order controller. Okay, it will have, we will have order service. For now we just create a simple constructor and then we can start writing our routes. It is in capital GET. Okay, this will be HTTP GET. And here the important part is we are going to use use guard. Here you can specify your multiple guards. So first of all I'm going to use auth guard, and I will be passing JWT. Let me just see auth guard we are getting from schema. Auth guard we are getting from Next.js passport controllers and all. It should be fine. Use guard auth guard. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to say okay, in the order list all my orders, and what we are going to have, we are going to have user as an entity, user as an input. User, and what we are going to get from there is the ID of the user from the user document. So user document we have to import from types user, so that we will just check. Okay, and now what we will do is we will have a service already created. So I'll just say private read only order service, right? We will import it and we'll create it and we'll import it. That is fine. So here we can just do this dot order service dot list all my orders. I mean, you can just change this method, list orders by user. So that method name explicitly saying what we are going to do is we are just passing the user ID. So you can capture this ID from the request parameter also. Okay, like here we do params, and like we are doing the same thing, annotations we are using for the user controller and auth controller. So in the auth controller we are passing @ body and ID. Right, similarly these are different placeholder we can use. Similarly we have params, I think. Okay, params, and here I got the ID of type any now. Okay, so I will be just passing this ID, list all my orders. Similarly you can have other methods, which is create new order for me. I wanted to buy one more item, so you will just create a post. I mean, we have written a lot of methods now, it should be very quick. It will be post, same as use guard we have to use. Create order for me. Create a new order. Right, in this case, we will be getting a few things in the body. So instead of params, we will just replace it with the body. Okay, what I'm going to get is I will have an order DTO which will specify what actually I'm going to use. Create order DTO which you can import. Okay, auth user DTO, order DTO. So we are going to define the entities also. So this is my DTO, and here I will define the API property. Okay, this I am importing in the order controller. Cool. And this ID, because what we are going to do is we will be passing two things, the logged in user and the ID. So we already have actually the logged in user session data somewhere, and we are just going to access it. So we will see how we can access the logged in user information, because we have to pass two things here, ID and payload. Payload means the order information, because we are going to create this order for this particular logged in user, right? And we are going to write the methods for this order service. So now how we can capture this information? Either you can just use in the middleware, you request.user equal to current logged in user, and in throughout your application you can access request.user information, request.user.email, request.user.id. But in the case of Nest.js, how can we manage that information? Either we can create a custom decorator for managing the user information, so that thing we have to take care. How we can, so what we just need to capture is, we just need to capture request.user information, because what passport is doing is it is adding the user information in the request, but request is not exposed when we use Nest.js. So we can create a custom annotation like something like this, export const equal to, here we have to import decorators from Nest.js, and we have common. From here we get one particular attribute, which is create param decorator, and this we can use to create a new decorator, and this actually accepts a function. Yes, that is correct. And here we have few things like data and the request, and this decorator we can use to capture the user information. Let me see what is wrong. Name is common. Export const, if I'm creating user annotation, and here should be request. Yeah, so I created a annotation user, so I will be able to use this annotation here. Just check an ID of type any. Yeah, this is the one way. So this is how we can access it. List all my orders also can be the same thing, because you are already logged in, right? So why should you will be passing your ID, user ID of any. So using this, what we are able to solve, we are able to solve our problem. We don't need to pass the ID, we can just capture the ID, and ID we are getting from this whole object. So this is a request.user, so you can capture the ID using this. So we got the ID from this request.user object. Clear? So clean, now it look clear. So what we are doing is list all my orders, we are passing ID, and here you can say we create my new order. Here you are passing ID and user. Right, now we can write an order service, and we are good with this. Thanks everyone.